don't wonder, why I do whatever I like. I do, what I like, I do, what I like, I do,
Just come with me. She wants both of us.
I'm not going over there.
Look at me. One, we're a salty sweet snack. Two, salty sweet snacks get eaten. And three, I prefer her versus hungry eyes over here.
Salty, sweet, and impossible to resist.
Somebody get this guy a bowl of nuts or something, please.
How in the world am I going to do an M&M inspired / recreation? And I ain't got no goddamn M&Ms. What type of shit is this? Hey, you guys. Welcome back to my channel. Yes, I'm back again with another video. Why is I gonna wanna be a YouTuber?
And I
today's video, as y'all can see by the title, as y'all can see by the little cute video I put in the beginning, your girl's gonna be creating herself into or transforming herself into an orange M&M. Now y'all know, well, you don't know. I always keep saying y'all know, like y'all know, but you really don't know yet until I tell you. This has been like my fourth or fifth time saying that to y'all. I love M&Ms. I love candy, I love chocolate, and I love M&Ms. This honestly just came out of nowhere, this whole idea of me trying to transform into an M&M. It was very random, and I want to do it. I want to see if I can transform myself into an M&M. And I kept looking through all the M&M characters, from the brown M&M to the green M&M to the blue M&M to the yellow and to the red. And then I also realized that we have orange. And I was like, you know what? I was like, why not do orange? You know what I'm saying? As y'all know, M&Ms are like one of the best candies ever, from the chocolate M&Ms to the peanut M&Ms to the crunchy M&Ms to the pretzel in the inside of the M&Ms. And then of course you guys know that they have their exotic random ass different flavor M&Ms as well. It's amazing. It's amazing. And yeah, of course, within M&Ms, they were brought into this world around September 10th of 1941. And of course the orange M&M, this cute little guy right here, he wasn't really put into the mix of M&Ms or added into the bunch of M&Ms until like the 1980s, which I think is really cool. But personally, within this M&M character, he is the spokesperson for the M&M crunch kind of M&Ms, which is when they brought in the M&M pretzels. And now, don't come for the M&M pretzels now, okay? Them shits are fire. Like, when I first see them, I'm not gonna lie, I did not really appreciate it. I was just like, okay, like, whatever. But when I actually got me a bag and I ate it, oh my god, like, it's really good. So he is like the spokesperson character creation to represent the crunchy candy of M&Ms, and specifically the pretzel M&Ms. So I thought, why not do him? He's so cute. He looks like he's just a shy guy, really nervous, gets spooked very easily. Like, I don't know, I just really want to transform into him and really bring him to life and see if I can bring him to life. But other than that, y'all, that's pretty much the point of this makeup tutorial, of this makeup look. I did hashtag M&M inspired makeup look. I didn't really see nobody transform into an M&M, and I also looked it up here on YouTube. I seen maybe like one or two, three glam looks that, you know, are inspired by M&Ms, but ain't nobody transformed to no M&M yet. So why not let me be the first, you know what I'm saying? Well, at least within an M&M character, you know what I mean? I got a little late. I was supposed to start like a few hours ago, but let's just hope and see what happens. You know what I'm saying? Let's see if we can get this done before sunset. Fingers crossed. Lord Jesus. But before we get into this video, why don't you guys go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Subscribe to your girl's channel. You already know what's good. And then go ahead and hit the notification bell as well, so you guys be notified every time I upload videos here like this, darling. Here onto my channel. You guys already know. Go ahead and follow your girl on all her social medias, which is her Instagram and her Twitter. You guys already know, if you're watching me desktop version, there are two links up in the banner. If you're watching me mobile, you can go to my about section, and there should be two links to my social medias there as well. And without further ado, you guys, let's go ahead and get into this video. Hey, you guys. So I went ahead and blocked these eyebrows off camera using the purple Elmers Glue Stick and using some Airspun Coty Translucent Powder in the shade Naturally Neutral. All the products that I've used within today's video that I don't show off camera will be in the description box down below, along with discount codes. Now, of course, I went ahead and primed off camera using the Pop Beauty 24K Face Base Blurring Radiance Primer and using the e.l.f. Hydrating Face Primer as well. And of course, what we're going into first is where I'm basically taking a black eyeliner pencil, and I'm basically sketching out a circle within the face. I did the same step within my Pizza Illusion makeup look. If you guys have not checked out the makeup tutorial, you definitely should go check it out. It's pretty freaking awesome, if I do say so myself. But yeah, I'm basically just doing the same step within that video that I'm doing within this one. Of course, I have to kind of sit back and realize that my face shape is going to be different no matter what, because I have a more oval face shape than a wide circle face shape, as if within to do the m&ms. So I kind of have to realize that and just try to sketch out the most decent looking circle that I possibly can without it looking too crazy. Now, of course, I'm going to take some black acrylic paint, and I'm taking my foundation applicator brush, and I'm just basically taking it all the way from pretty much my collarbone up my neck and the side of my face, under my chin, my jawline. And then, of course, we're going to drag it up to the sides of the face. We're painting the whole entire perimeter of the circle. And then, of course, we're also going to have to drag that paint onto my ears. One of the most weirdest parts that I have to do, but I got to do what I got to do, y'all, to really, you know, make the makeup look come to life, to make that illusion of it all come to life at the end of the day. So we got to take it up them baby hairs. We got to do everything. Now, to get this color, I took some pure white grease face makeup paint. And then I also took the covergirl Trublend matte made foundation in the shade Elton. And then I also took some orange acrylic paint. Now, of course, this actually looks a little bit more darker on camera, off camera, in person, than it does on camera. It looks pretty light. I don't know why it does, but it just does. Now, of course, I'm basically just taking this. I swirled it as much as I can on the palm of my hand, and basically just taking it and just filling in the whole entire circle that we sketched out, going over the brows, the chin, everywhere. I personally don't mind if it has creasage, because we're going to be setting this with translucent powder, and then we're going to add a bunch of powder on top of that, color powder, to kind of cover up any mistakes or mess up or any streaks within this. I just need a decent base to start off with. Y'all, why do I look like the cheese, that wimpy cheese on the Diary of a Wimpy Kid, y'all? The cheese touch, the cheese touch.
Stop! Good God, man, you almost got the cheese touch.
I swear that is exactly what I pictured in my mind, but you know what, we did it. We did it. So basically, I'm taking that Airspun Coty translucent powder in the shade Naturally Neutral, taking that powder puff, and I'm just going in to set the face. Like I said before, and about a few or a couple of my makeup looks that involve me having to transition to a different color, you always want to set the face. It does not matter if you use face paint, if you use that expensive face paint, Halloween makeup face paint. Doesn't matter if you use regular makeup within foundation, concealer, doesn't matter. Any type of cream product within liquid product that you put on your face, you have to set it with powder, because you do not want it to move around when you're applying layers of different powders or other paints, creams, liquids, or whatever you're applying on top of that. You need it to set and be completely matte. So after that, I'm basically just taking my powder brush and just dusting off all that excess powder. I usually do this within my glam makeup looks as well, because I just feel like it's a perfect step within doing this. Yes, it is a little extra, but it definitely helps and it benefits within it as well. So I'm basically just taking the Black Radiance Bold and Sexy Face and Eyeshadow Palette again, and I'm taking that orange shade. It looks kind of reddish orange on camera, but in person it actually is just a really vibrant orange. And I'm also taking the lightest shade and the darkest shade of orange within the Morphe collaboration with Jaclyn Hill
Volt eyeshadow palette, Ring the Alarm. Of course, I'm going to start with the light shade orange in the Morphe palette. I'm basically just taking that on a very small, precise brush that I use personally for the face. And I'm just taking that and I'm just kind of packing it on. At first, it didn't look like it was giving any coverage, but once I actually completed it within my face, it definitely was. You just have to really be patient with this. You have to take your time and make sure you're covering the whole entire face, from your forehead to the eyebrows to the creases within your nose, around the lips, everywhere. Of course, now once we get done with that, we're going in with a darker shade of orange. Now, of course, to me, I feel like within the orange M&M, it has a little bit of a contour, has a little bit of shadow towards the bottom and kind of a little bit towards the perimeter of the M&M. It's a little bit more lighter in the center, like it's highlighted. And then, of course, within half of the bottom towards the perimeter, it's kind of shaded a little bit more darker. So I'm taking that shade from the Bold and Sexy Face and Eyeshadow Palette, and I'm mixing it with the dark orange within the Morphe palette, mixing both of those together and just honestly contouring the face and giving it some shadow. Y'all look like a cheetah.
It ain't easy being cheesy.
Okay, I look like a straight cheetah. Okay. And of course, I'm just going double in with that dark orange, and I'm kind of just going around within the perimeters, but I'm also doing very light taps within the center as well, because I'm just trying to get that nice decent blend of light orange and dark orange at the same time. And it's okay if you get some on the edge within the black area with within the face, because you can easily go over it with some black paint, so it doesn't even matter. But yeah, you just basically want to take your time with this, make sure you're packing on as much as you possibly can. And yeah, so once I personally feel like I've gotten enough, which of course seems like I'm still going, and I'm still going. I think I went in with some light orange again, actually, to balance it out, because I think I was starting to really look like a really burnt orange Cheeto. But now I feel like it's kind of balanced out between both of them. So now we are actually getting into the eyes. I'm basically just taking some of that Pure White Grease face paint, and I'm basically we're going in with the brows. I'm basically just taking some black acrylic paint, and I'm basically just trying to sketch out my brows as much as possible. Now, of course, I definitely was looking at a reference picture. I usually mention this in my intros, but I definitely was looking at a reference picture, because I honestly can't really think of the orange M&M off of the top of my head like that. I'm sorry, I just, that's just not me, that's just not how I roll. Okay, so of course I was looking at a reference picture of his eyebrows to really see like how different shape and formed it is, and of course I tried my best to do it. And I realized that in the beginning, I maybe shouldn't have covered up my forehead 100% completely, because you can't even see half of the eyebrows from the top. So later on in the video, I definitely do, you know, fix that. And of course, I did want to do one eye off camera just to speed up time, because I really didn't know how I was going to construct his eyelids. His eyelids are one of those things that are really hard to capture, because he's such a nervous, shy guy. So he gives his facial expressions of being really nervous to where his eyebrows are raised really, really high. So it's kind of hard to see them within some pictures, but I had like a good 2 or 3 reference pictures that really showed the difference within his eyelids. So basically I'm just sketching it out using some LA Color brown liquid eyeliner. At first I'm sketching that out, and then once I feel like I got the decent enough sketch, I'm taking that small precise paintbrush, and of course I did wipe it off first, and I'm basically just taking some dark orange eyeshadow and I'm just applying that on top, because his eyelids are matched within the same of his actual like face. Is not really showing within any dark color, so I wanted to keep that same energy within my eyelids. I wanted to, you know, make it more of a dark orange to kind of blend in with his actual face. And then of course I went ahead and took a little bit of foundation, and I basically just kind of carved the inside of the eyelids just so I can apply a little bit of a light orange just to give it a little bit of highlight. So I'm basically just going in with that same small precise paintbrush, and then once we go within that, basically I'm taking that dark orange and I'm really shading in within the bottom. And basically all I did was take a little bit of yellow from the Bold and Sexy Face palette, added that in the center, then took some orange and added that in the center, and then I went back in with that dark orange and I kind of built up the perimeters within the inside of the eyelid. I hope that all makes sense, but y'all know what I'm talking about. I'm basically just highlighting and shading within the eyelids basically. And then after all of that, basically going back in with that dark brown liquid eyeliner, and I'm basically just kind of going over it within certain spots and really going light-handed. I'm not going too heavy because, like I said, we still want it to show, but we don't want it to look, see what I mean, we don't want it to look completely dark. And now I'm going with that pure white grease face paint, and I'm basically just applying that all over within the eyes, because the M&M eyes are pretty big, they are pretty wide. There is really no precise look. It's actually just kind of circled as much as possible. So once within that being applied within the face, then I'm taking a flat eyeshadow brush and I'm taking some of that white translucent powder within the Pop Beauty Setting 101 palette. And I'm basically just setting the pure white grease face paint. And I'm just taking it and tapping it very lightly. Just going very light-handed pretty much, and just making sure I'm covering every single spot. And then of course, when we get into that, now we are going to start with the mouth. Now the mouth was one of those things where I was like, how am I going to construct the M&M's mouth knowing that my big ass nose is in the center of my face? But you know what, I just try to say, you know what, you girl, just finesse the shit. Like, just, you know, try your best to, you know, really bring that illusion of life to where, you know, people, I feel like people will still recognize him even with my nose being in the center, because y'all know M&M's don't got no noses. So I try to bring my mouth as close as possible to where I can cover up at least the nostrils of my nose, so that way you guys can't really see, like, oh, she got a big old nose in the center of it, you know what I mean? So I basically just followed the same type of lines within the M&M's face, because y'all know he's a very shy, nervous guy, okay? So his mouth is always structured with him looking very nervous and stuff, or he's like quivering in fear. So that's the type of mouth shape that I pretty much did, and I'm basically just filling it in with black and sketch it out first with black paint, and then I'm filling it in with black paint. And then I'm also taking that burgundy shade, I'm taking that dark orange shade, and I'm basically creating a shadow for his bottom lip, because within one of the reference pictures that I was looking at, I could see a little bit of shadow making within his bottom lip. So I thought to do the same thing, basically just taking that small precise paintbrush, dust it off of course, and then I dipped into the shadows and just kind of lightly sketched it out. In fact, did I use burgundy or did I use brown? I don't know if I used brown or burgundy or if I used both. Honestly, I don't know, but I just tried my best. So that's what I did. Basically taking some white paint, and we're basically going to be creating the M for the M&M. Now, of course, I tried to make it within centered within the face as much as possible. And I'm not perfect with it. I tried my best. That M&M is the hardest M I feel like I've ever had to make. But basically, I just took some L10 foundation by Covergirl, the Trublend matte made one. I made the arms and the legs. And I basically just took some airspunofficial translucent powder to set it. And then I went in with the Covergirl Reverence eyeshadow palette. And I basically took that very, like, fair shade. And then I basically took that first contouring shade, and I've set both of those on top because they actually look a little bit more tan in some pictures, and then some other pictures they look pretty light slash fair. So I just kind of mixed in with both. But now I'm taking some black paint and we're creating the eyes, and basically just made some oval shapes within the center of the eyes, and then went in with some white paint and kind of created some smaller oval shape within the center of the black. And then of course I actually did go black I actually did go back in with some black paint to kind of cover up some of that white a little bit too, because I realized that his eyes within the white is a little bit smaller. So I did a little bit of covering it off camera as well, even more. And now I'm basically just setting the face with just a little bit of the e.l.f. Cosmetics makeup mist and setting spray, just to set the face, but not, you know, too much. Yeah, you guys, this is pretty much it to the finished look. Like I said, I low-key wish I added some of his white fingers within his white gloves onto the makeup look. But you know what? I'm going to take it for what it is, and I enjoy the way it looks just as a whole. And I also did take that makeup wipe, and I did wipe away some of that black so you guys could really see his eyebrows fully come to life within the makeup look. And this is pretty much it, you guys.
Okay, you guys, and this right here is the finished look. Honestly, I personally love this. Oh my goodness. This came out, honestly, more than what I thought it was going to come out to be. I'm being honest. What I did do off camera was I went ahead, you guys kind of seen how it was throughout the tutorial. I basically just took a wipe, and I just kind of wiped away the black so you can really see the eyebrows come through. Because I try my best with the legs, and of course, you know, the arms can only go so far. But other than that, I really do like this look. Orange M&M, period. But if you guys like this look, if you guys enjoyed it, please give this video a big old thumbs up, and then comment down below any other makeup look suggestions that you guys would like for me to do here onto my channel as well. Don't mind my ashy hands. It was a lot of wiping, a lot of applying, a lot of wiping. You know what I'm saying? But can we also just talk about the fact that your girl got this done before sunset? That's what I'm talking about. And also, sorry to disappoint anybody that wanted to see me do the shoes. I personally just did not feel like doing that. That is a lot of detail within white and then like light grays and dark grays to really get the definition and detail within the white shoe. I ain't finna do all that. You know what I'm saying? We just gonna keep it towards the legs and call it a motherfucking day, okay? But also, why don't you guys go ahead and hit that subscribe button, subscribe to your girl's channel, and why don't you guys also go ahead and hit that notification bell so you guys can be notified every time I upload videos here like this, honey. Like I said in the intro, here on my channel, okay? And also, comment down below what type of M&Ms do you guys like. Do you guys like the exotic flavors that they come out? Do you guys only like certain holiday M&Ms, like the Easter M&Ms, the Valentine's Day M&Ms? Do you guys like the peanut M&Ms? Do you like the chocolate M&Ms? Do you like the pretzel M&Ms? Let me know what your favorite flavor of M&Ms or favorite kind of M&Ms down in the comments below as well. And yeah, you guys, like I said, I really do enjoy this look. I wish my face was a little bit more rounder so you could really see the structure of it, because if I pull it back a little bit and kind of widen it, you really see it come to life. But sadly, I have an oval shaped head. I don't have a circle shaped head, a complete circle shaped head, by the way. You know, you gotta work with what you gotta work with. You know what I'm saying? You gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, and also, I know I'm asking y'all a lot for the comment section, but also comment down below, what's your favorite M&M character? Do you like the blue M&M? Do you like the yellow M&M? Do you like the green M&M? Do you like the brown M&M? Do you like the red M&M? Or are you like me and you on the orange M&M side, okay? Let me also know that down in the comment section as well. And like I said, I hope you guys like this look. I hope you guys truly enjoyed it. I'm very proud of myself. I enjoyed this look. I enjoyed creating it. This was definitely a fun moment. And yeah. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.